Welcome to Sushmita's Maths class. Here, Maths is made so easy that you will all start loving it. Children, today we will be studying about exponents and powers. We often need to multiply a number by itself several times. For example, for finding area of a square, we do side into side. So we can also call it as side square. Now for finding the volume of a cube, we need to multiply side 3 times. And we call it side cube. So if the side is 2 cm, we will multiply 2 into 2 and we get 4 cm square. So we can call it as 2 square. Now, if the side of a cube is 2 cm, so we can write it as 2 to the power of 3. That is 2 to the 4, 4 to the 8. So we are multiplying 2 3 times, that is the 2, this is called the base, and this, the number of times we are multiplying, comes over here, and this we call as power or the exponent. So this will be 8 cubic centimeter or centimeter cube. Now, power or exponent tells us how many times the base is repeated. When a number doesn't have an exponent, it is understood to be 1. For example, if I write 2, then the exponent is 2 to the power of 1. And the value of a number with 0 as its exponent is always 1. See, for example, 2 to the power of 0 is 1. Even 3 to the power of 0 is 1. Any number to the power of 0 is 1. Okay, let's do an activity to show the value of the power. See, this is a sheet and it has not been folded. So this is whole one sheet. That means 2 to the power of 0 means whole one sheet. Now if we fold it once, this is 2 to the power of 1. That means fold it once. So we get 2 parts. So 2 to the power of 1 is equal to 2. Now if we fold it into, fold it twice. See, this is the paper. We are folding it once and again we are folding it. So we have folded it twice. That is 2 to the power of 2. So it will give 2 into 2 is equal to 4. So see, we have got 4 pieces. 4 parts, 1, 2, 3 and 4. So these 4 parts. Now we fold this again into the next fold, that is the third fold. That means we can say that is 2 to the power of 3. Now we will get 8 parts. See, if we open up 1, 2, 3, 4 on one side and 5, 6, 7, 8. The same paper, first when we have folded it once, we are getting 2 parts. When we are folding it twice, we are getting 4 parts. And now when we have folded it thrice, we have got 8 parts in this paper. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. The power of 3, that means the base is repeated 3 times. So 3 threes are 9 and 9 threes are 27. 5 to the power of 4. So this is 5. This is the base and this is the exponent. So 4 times, I have to repeat 5, and let's see, 25 into 25 is equal to 625. I think you all know the multiplication of the number ending with 5. So what we do is 5 fives are 25, and then one number is increased by 1. That is, this 2 will be multiplied with the next number. So 2 threes are 6. See, this is how we multiply. Now, when the base is negative and the power or the exponent is even, let's find the value. It will be positive. For example, let's take 5 minus 5. Here we have done 5 to the power of 4. Both are positive. Now when we take negative number and the exponent is positive, that is, we have to repeat it 4 times. Children, when we write like this, always put a bracket, because the two signs cannot come together. Now when we multiply negative into negative, then again negative, negative. So these two negative, we get positive 25. Again these two negative, when we multiply, we get positive 25. And the answer is positive number. But when the base is negative and power is odd, base is negative and the power is odd, the value is negative. Here the power is even. So we have multiplied negative number 4 times. Now we multiply 5 3 times. This is odd power. This was even power. This is odd power. So minus multiplied by minus is positive, and again multiplied by a negative number. So the answer will be negative 125. Here we follow the rules of the integers. Never multiply the base with the exponent. Next, exponent on rational numbers. Let's see. Exponents on rational number. By b to the power of n. Here we get a to the power of n and b to the power of n. Let's take an example of 2 by 3 to the power of 3. So here 2 is multiplied thrice, and again 3 is multiplied thrice. So we can write it as 2 to the power of 3 and 3 to the power of 3. This comes to be 8 upon 27. Writing 8 into 8 into 8 into 8 and so on, m times. So we can write it like 8 to the power of m. So for expressing in power notation, what we have to do is factorization. Suppose we are given this number 343 upon 125. So here we have to do factorization. Let's see. 343. Children, you all know this is equal to 7 cube. And 125 is equal to 5 cube. But here the sign is negative. That means minus 7 whole cube upon 5 cube, or we can write minus 7 by 5 whole cube. If the power is negative, then we have to write the reciprocal of the base to make the power positive. For example, if this is a to the power of minus 4, we will write the reciprocal of the base number to make the power positive. That is, reciprocal of the base number is this, and when we write it like this, the power will be positive. Say a to the power of minus m. This is same as 1 by a to the power of m. 2 to the power of minus 3, we can write it like 1 by 2, this is the reciprocal of the base number, to the power of 3. If we have 2 by 5 to the power of 2 to the power minus 2 minus 5. Now, here we solve it like this. 2 by 5 minus 3, and then make it 5 by 2. So reciprocal of 2 by 5, we can write it as 1 upon 2 by 5, then the power negative becomes positive. Now 1 upon 2 by 5 is equal to 5 upon 2 to the power of positive 3. Now 5 upon 2 to the power of positive 3 means 5 3 times and 2 3 times, and that comes to be 125 upon 8. We have different laws for exponents. Now the first one is multiplying numbers with the same base but different exponents. So when the base is same and the powers are different, we add the powers. That means multiply, add powers. So here 5 to the power of minus 3 multiplied by 5 to the power of 4. Here we will add the power, means minus 3 plus 4. So here we get 5 to the power of 1, and that is equal to 5. So here we are using whatever we have learnt in integers. 3 by 5 to the power of 2 multiplied by 3 to the 5, 3 by 5 to the power of 3. Here also we will add 3 to the power of 5. 2 plus 3, that is 3 to the power of 3 by 5 to the power of 5. So this comes to be 243 and 3125. Now in the second one, base is same and power different, and when we are dividing, we have to subtract the powers. That is BM divided by BN, that is BM minus N. Here M should be bigger than N. Now 3 to the power of 4 divided by 3 to the power of 2, that is 3 to the power of 4 minus 2, subtract 3 to the power of 2, that is 3 into 3 is equal to 9. Children, whatever we have done here, see, we can do it in this manner. 3 to the power of 4 divided by 3 to the power of 2. We can write it like this, numerator and denominator. Then 3 to the power of 4 means 3, 4 times, 3 to the power of 2. means 3 2 times. Now this is cancellation. 3 into 3 is equal to 9. See, the answer is same. Finding exponential value of a number which already has an exponent. Multiply both the exponents in this case. X to the power of m whole to the power of n. So here what we do is we multiply m and n. Here 2 is the base. X was the base, here 2 is the base. So we multiply 3 into 5, that is 2 to the power of 15. Here it is x m n. Here 2 to the power of 8 into minus 2. So 2 to the power of minus 16. And we should not leave the number with negative exponent. So we will write 1 by 2 to the power 16. Now here, what does it mean? Why do you think we write it like this? See, this is minus 3 whole square and that is multiplied 4 times. Minus 3 whole square into minus 3 whole square into minus 3 whole square. So we have already discussed when we multiply the same basis, we add the power. So it comes to be minus 3 to the power of 8. Here also it comes to be minus 3 to the power of 8. And when
positive this number
is minus 3, negative 3 and the power is even, so we will get as answer. The fourth law, multiplying two different numbers with same exponent. So when we have x to the power of m multiplied by y to the power of m, we multiply these two numbers, x into y and then to the power of m. See, 2 to the power of 3 and 4 to the power of 3, we can write it as 2 4s are 8 to the power of 3. So it is 5 1 2. Now what actually we are doing, we are multiplying 2 3 times and 4 3 times. So 8 multiplied by 64 is equal to 512. If we have 2 by 3 to the power of 2 multiplied by 3 by 5 to the power of 2, we multiply 2 3s are 2 by 3 into 3 by 5 to the power of 2. So here it is 6 by 15 to the power of 2. So 6 6 are 36 and 15 15 is 225. And same will be the answer when we are multiplying like this. 2 by 3 2 times and again 3 by 5 2 times. So 2 2s are 4, 3 3s are 9. 3 3s are 9 and 5 5s are 25. 4 9s are 36 and 25 9s are 225. Law, dividing numbers with same exponent. That is dividing when the bases are different and the power same. See, a to the power m divided by b to the power m. This is a by b to the power m. So if we take it as 2 to the power 3 and 5 to the power 3, we can write it as 2 by 5 to the power of 3. So 2 into 2 into 2, and 5 into 5 into 5, that is 8 upon 125. Now we will study how to write the numbers in standard form. How to write numbers in standard form. So standard form is also known as scientific notation. We write the numbers in the form of m multiplied by n to 10 to the power of n. M multiplied by 10 to the power of n, where m is a decimal number. And m is greater than equal to 1. And this n can either be a positive greater than equal to 1. N, this n, that is the power, either it is positive or negative. Let's see where n is positive and where it is negative. Since very big numbers is very difficult to remember, so to avoid inconvenience, mathematicians decided to write the standard form of a number. Now this is a big number which is very difficult to remember. Maybe where this number is written, the decimal is over here. Now we have to put it in such a way that m is a decimal number and m is greater than 1. So we have to bring this decimal over here. How many digits? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So we keep just one number as whole number and then put decimal and we write this. Now since if we have the decimal over here and we have to shift it over here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, we will write it as 10 to the power of 6. Remember in the video of decimal, I have taught you multiply right. Means when this decimal point has to be shifted towards right, we multiply. And the number of digits it is to be shifted is written over here. And here we already have a decimal over here, but we have to write it in standard form. So we have to bring the decimal over here. So we'll write it like this, 4.63 multiplied by. If we are putting decimal over here, actually we need it over here. That means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 digits we have to shift left hand side. So we have to shift left hand side, that means divide by 10 to the power of 5, that means multiply by 10 to the power of minus 5. Multiplicative inverse of 2 to the power minus 3 is 1 by 2 to the power minus 3. And we should not leave a number in negative power. So we make it 2 to the power 3. This shows 2 inverse of 2 to the power negative 3 is 2 to the power positive 3. So reciprocal of 1 - n is a to the power n. If you find it useful, do like, share, and subscribe.